Stephen, what kind of problems would be a good match for this dynamic parallelism capability? So as programmers are thinking about what techniques to use in designing their next generation algorithms, what are the things where dynamic parallelism is really going to make a difference for them?
I guess when I think about the features that I want to add to CUDA, I really want to make it easier to write the programs you want to write. And dynamic parallelism, I think, really gives you much more flexibility in how you write your code. So as well as things like recursive algorithms, which are extremely difficult without it, sometimes it's just easy to write a program wholly on the GPU, for example. If I know that my program is a small iterative loop launching lots of parallel work, it might be just simply easy to write the whole thing on the GPU and have a GPU thread control the whole thing from scratch. So if I'm in a situation where my memory marshalling backwards and forwards between CPU and GPU would be complex or difficult, if I put my whole program on the GPU, all my memory is in one place and it's much easier to write. So the first kind of problem I would look at is one which would just be made easier by keeping all of your code in one place. You may not necessarily go any faster. Remember, serial execution on the GPU is slower than serial execution on the CPU. When you're developing code, even though you might be able to get something working faster if you do a CPU and GPU combination, typically, you know, as I say, I came from a science background, you don't have 6 months to tune your code. You've got 4 weeks before your paper deadline. So the question is not how good can I get it, it's how good can I get it in 4 weeks before my paper is due. And so if I can give something like dynamic parallelism, which will make it easier to get as good as you can in 4 weeks, you might only get to 75% of performance in 4 weeks, but if without it you'd only get to 50% of performance, you can do that much more science in the time you have available. So in spite of the new types of algorithm that it lets you do, and those are very interesting because it lets you approach things on the GPU you simply couldn't do before, I think the first step is to say, well, does this just make my life easier? Because if it makes your life easier, you can spend your time focusing on doing the science or the calculation you need to do rather than wondering how on earth do I program this thing in the first place.